Dads, for Father's Day, I'm challenging you to save our daughters. They're crying out for you. I'll be right back to tell you about my Father's Day challenge. Don't touch the remote. See you in a second.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success from the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Yes, dads, June, Father's Day, right? But I have a challenge for you. And my challenge is for you to save our daughters. Daughters are crying out, really crying out for dads. And we're going to be talking more today on Inspire Success. With me in the studio, Abdul Muhammad, right? Abdul Muhammad of My People's Clinical Services right here in Hartford, Connecticut. Yes. So welcome, Abdul, to Inspired Success.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
It's a pleasure. It's a real pleasure. So let's dive right into this conversation about the cry. I believe I am hearing that cry. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure whether most people are, but I hear a cry, the cries of our daughters, mm-hmm. really crying out for their dads, crying out for the presence of their dads in their life, you know, emotionally, you know, financially, just to be involved in their lives. Yes. And, you know, so you talk to me about that. What are the statistics? What's going on in Black America, especially mm-hmm. as far as absentee fathers, you know, and the increasing women head of household? You know, what's going on, you know, from your professional expertise?
Right. Well, it's definitely a dilemma,
yeah.
especially in our community, in the Black community.
Yes.
We have a large number of mother-headed households. Fathers
yes.
are not involved in those households. And we know that for our daughters especially, that when a father's not involved in their life, they don't have a role model for them to choose a mate in the future.
Okay.
They don't. They miss
Absolutely.
Out. They miss out on a lot of those small things that fathers bring to the table. Small and large things that
yes.
fathers bring to the table. So an involved father actually changes the whole life plan for his daughter, because he shows her a man that treats his their mother with respect.
Okay, exactly.
He models someone going to work every day.
Yes.
He models somebody
responsibility.
Responsibility.
Exactly.
He models kindness and how he takes this child to go see things. You know, when fathers aren't involved, the children miss out on exposure to things. So you know, I go out and I speak to children all the time. You know how many children have never been to New York City?
Wow,
like, just think about how, like, when for us, like, for people
yeah.
like ourselves, right? So you think when a child tells you, you know, my dream is to go to New York City.
Wow.
So you think
wow.
to yourself, like, New York is
right
there.
Exactly.
But when
there's no dad.
There's no dad. That means there's less money in the household. There's
exactly.
less exposure in the household.
Yes.
So that means that mothers are just trying to get by.
Exactly.
They're trying to
they're
make it.
Probably two, three,
maybe
four jobs.
To just get
and
by.
So, and so that leaves the kids alone.
Right.
And for the girls especially, you touched on a couple of things here.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you say? You touched on the, you know, the fact that the men and the fathers are the one who really model how to be treated,
yes.
how a mate should treat them, where the way they treat their mother, you
mm-hmm.
know, they model to them responsibility, you
mm-hmm.
know, how a man is supposed to, you know, care and take care of his family and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
And so what do you think that the cry is really? Because I see a lot of it. I see a lot of young girls, you know, our daughters,
mm-hmm.
looking for love in all the wrong places.
Yes.
Looking for affirmation, mm-hmm. you know, and then the way they carry themselves, the way they dress, mm-hmm. you know, the increased rates in promiscuity. Mm-hmm. I think all those are the cries.
Yes.
The crying for the fathers. And so, I mean, as they cry out, how can fathers really respond mm-hmm. to alleviate and to help to, you know, fulfill them emotionally? How yeah. can fathers step in? Because some fathers are ill-equipped because they were never fathered.
That's true.
Okay.
That's true.
They were never fathered. And so it's now they suddenly find themselves in this role of father and they don't know what to do.
Well, this is the thing about fatherhood. This is the thing about parenting in
yes.
general.
Yes.
There's no perfect parent. There's no
yes.
perfect father. The most important thing that a father can do for his daughter
yes.
is be involved.
Yes.
The most important thing a father can do for his son is just be there. So that's a starting point. By
yes.
being involved and by being there, it opens up doors for them. So if they don't know all the like technical stuff and the logistical
yes.
things, the things from the book, that's okay. Well, what we know is that fathers bring something to the table that mothers don't. You know, when I'm with my children, when I play with my son and my daughter, we roughhouse. We run around and sometimes they might end up crying at the end of the game, right?
Right.
But it's because that's how fathers do stuff.
Yes,
you know, I
yes.
might swing my son around. My wife would never do that, right?
Yes.
But it's because fathers do things in a unique way. And so our way of doing things gives our daughters, gives our sons a new way of seeing the world. And so when there's no father involved, you take away that whole perspective, that whole worldview. But
yes.
also
exactly.
when fathers are involved, you take away also all of his family, all of the people in his family that have made an impact on his life, you know, they're gone as well. So
yes.
you don't have so the resources that when you have a two-parent household or
yes.
even a household with a father, maybe he's not in the household, but he's involved.
But he's involved. He's present.
And
that's
so,
the key. He's
so
involved.
We keep going back to that, is that the presence of him. Even when, you know, your child learns something
yes.
when you are sitting on the couch doing absolutely nothing. You know,
that's huge. I'm going to stop you right there because I think that's very, very important because I know that a lot of the men who are watching today are saying to themselves, I don't have the tools. I don't know how to be a father.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't fathered myself. My father wasn't present, you
right.
know.
Mm-hmm.
And out of fear,
yeah.
you know, they're not doing anything.
Mm.
But this is what I have heard you say, that just being present, just show up.
Right.
That's all you need to do.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what you're saying to the dad.
Yes.
Just show up.
Show up.
Just be there.
They got to be there.
And as long as you're there, that your presence is speaking volumes to the children, to the daughters, and the sons even.
So the other day I was at the house, right? And a song came on the television, and I started dancing with my wife, and I was putting on my cufflinks, and you know, it was just us fooling around.
Yes.
And out of the corner of my eye, I saw my son.
Yeah.
Copying exactly the moves that I was doing, and so I wasn't doing that for his benefit.
Yeah.
I was doing it for my benefit, you know?
Yes.
But so the realization is that by me being me,
yes.
a dad, being there early in the morning, we're getting ready to go to work and school.
Yes.
This little boy is able to see this.
It's
exactly going into his mind.
Assimilate all of that.
And the thing is,
assimilate,
the same
yes.
things that I do now are similar to the things that when I used to watch my father.
Yes.
You know, my dad is probably one of the biggest role models in my life. You know, my father's a social worker, I'm a social worker.
Yeah.
My father's an alpha, I'm an alpha.
Yeah.
I want to do everything my dad does.
Yeah.
And sometimes, you know, we go through that phase where we try to pull away.
I'm going
to be my own person.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
But the reality is, now, but somebody the other day, it was an amazing thing. Somebody said to me, you're starting to look just like your dad. And I was just saying, like, you know, and my dad has a big beard and all. But I was just thinking to myself, like, I guess I'm getting to
that phase.
And
yes.
so, fatherhood is And that's the thing. That's the other thing. Fatherhood is not just for when they're babies and when they're, you know, little and when they're teenagers.
It's something that goes on through the entire life. And one moment. So if you're tuning in, if you're just tuning in, this is Inspired Success with Princess Bola. And today on Inspired Success, I have Abdul. Actually, you're yet to tell viewers about, give them a little bit about your background professionally, because they need to know that you're coming from both personal experience, you know, and as well as professional training. So I have Abdul Muhammad, who is the you're the founder and CEO of My People's Clinical Services, you know, social worker in Hartford, Connecticut, and also the founder of the Daddy-Daughter Dance that is coming up on Saturday, June 20th in East Hartford, Connecticut. We'll be getting to that in a minute. But tell them a little bit about, you know, your background. Tell viewers a little bit about your background, you know, and how you really came into My People's Clinical Services, as well as this Daddy-Daughter Dance that we're going to be talking about more about in a few seconds.
Well, I mean, I have a master's in social work from Clark Atlanta University. And, you know, for years I worked at different agencies in the area. And, you know, one day I decided I wanted to start my own agency because I realized that I wasn't a very good employee. I think I would be, I thought to myself, I would probably be a really good boss, but I'm not a very good employee. So when I was thinking about starting My People, I was saying, like, you know, what is it that I know about? What is it that I'm good at that's not being offered in the marketplace? One of the things about My People is we always try to fill
find
a gap.
Exactly, and find your niche.
My niche. So when I did my master's thesis, my thesis was on fatherhood. I did a program review in Atlanta, Georgia, of a program called Father to Father. I actually stole that name. But basically, so what I did, I said, you know what? I'm gonna create a group and a case management program. And that was my only goal initially. I was going to create this fatherhood program. And at the time, 10 years ago, nobody was really doing fatherhood.
Yes,
it was like at the right time, you know, in the right place for us to do it.
And so, you know, with your fatherhood program and that initiative, what is it exactly that you do for fathers? You know, what kind of tools do you provide for them? And
we have a weekly group where fathers come together, and we have a curriculum we use called the 24/7 Dad Curriculum. We also sometimes use the Nurturing Fathers Curriculum, and that's just it. We teach them those skills that you keep asking about as it pertains to, you know, how do you be a nurturing father?
Okay,
how do you deal with it, you know, your past not having a father in your life, or the way your father might have treated you, like, so, because everything we learn from our father is not necessarily good.
Absolutely.
And so how do you let go of some of the things that you don't want to add into your fatherhood?
Absolutely, absolutely. How do you become the ideal father, you know?
Yes.
You know, because like you said, not every person had a positive father role model.
Right.
And that brings me to another subject. Before we now talk about, you know, whether it is different, especially daughters, I want to, you know, want to say what is so different. I believe that both genders need their fathers in their life. I believe the father plays a crucial role. When I look at it, even from a spiritual, biblical perspective, you know, it is the father who names the child, who speaks the child. The kind of identity, a sense of identity comes from the father, you know, because even biologically, we know that the father is the one who determines the identity, the sex of the child.
That's right.
So that is so important in terms of a child feeling whole, this sense of wholeness and sense of identity and knowing where they come from and their roots and all of that. I feel it's so crucial, you know, that plays a unique role in that sense, you know, that mothers cannot play. But, you know, but let's talk about that as well in terms of, okay, now I, you know, for example, I personally struggled for many years with the Heavenly Father, God, because I was projecting some of my experiences with my biological father on him. And then also with my you know, love relationships with men, you know, the way you conceptualize men can be good or bad based on your experience with, your father, okay? And that is why, like you said earlier, it's so important that the fathers be present to speak and to model, to model how they should be treated, how a woman should be treated. And why is that very important for daughters in particular? Why do you think that is crucial for the girls, maybe more so than the boys, in terms of having, you know, their father's model, you know, love, how to be a gentleman, going on a date, what to expect, you know, how to be treated, you know, not just viewed as body parts and and that kind of thing. How do you, why do you think it's particularly important for the daughters? And what, how did you come, I guess two questions in one, how did you come about the daughter, daddy-daughter dance?
Well,
that's
goes
coming
back
up on June 20th.
To everything you just said, so
two questions in one.
Right. So,
why is it more important for daughters? You have
two daughters,
both from a professional and a personal point of view. So you have two daughters and a son. So is there a difference? Have you noticed a difference in way you interact with them and they interact with you?
Well, my daughter and my son, the little ones, because the older one's gone.
Okay.
But the little ones, they both have two totally different personalities.
Yes.
You know, so my daughter is very emotional about most stuff, you know.
Exactly.
You can say anything to her and she might start crying.
Yes.
And my son is kind of like, whatever. And he, you know, and so I think that, you know, but then also she, you know, the other day she came up with a new term called creativitas. And so she said she's a creativitist. And basically she's saying she's a creative person.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we were in Michael's and she's picking out different stuff that she needs to do so she can be creativitist. And so she comes up with that and I stole the word. I've been telling everybody that I'm creativitist now. And so it's like, but that builds her self-esteem, you know? So like something as simple as that, you know, my daughter, she goes around the house doing flips and cartwheels and all this stuff all the time.
Yeah.
Hey dad, look at this. Now, the attention that she gets from me, that's a positive attention.
Yes.
I have to stop what I'm doing, right?
Yes.
To give her that 2 seconds of attention while she does that cartwheel.
So she doesn't need to go and look for it out there.
That's
she
right.
She doesn't need to try and get
that's
the attention
right. she get it
from
me.
Others because she gets it from
that's
you.
Right. That's right.
That is huge.
It starts with me.
Yes,
so
absolutely.
When she gets older, because she knows she's 9 right now.
Yes.
But as she gets older, she understands that, you know, I don't have to
go out of my way, seek it from
that's
anybody.
Right.
I get all of what I need,
that's
and
right.
it feeds me emotionally from my father.
My
you
father.
Know, you
yes.
know, he's my, he's proud of me, and
yes.
he's my cheerleader, and he
yes.
believes in me.
Right.
And that's why it's particularly very important for the daughters. I agree with you, because they're more emotional. You know, the way women are wired, they need that affirmation. They need that constant attention,
right.
you know, more so than the men, than the boys, you know. And so it's very important. You know, if you're just tuning in, by the way, it's Inspired Success. It's Princess Bola with Abdul having this very animated conversation about fathers. And I'm posing a challenge to you fathers for Father's Day. You know, so it's not just about you getting gifts and presents.
Right.
It's really challenging you to save our daughters and hear their cry. You know, they're really crying out. They're acting up. You know, a lot of daughters. I see a lot of people on Facebook. I was watching. I was looking at some photos of the worst dressed worst prom dresses, and I looked at some of it. Mostly girls.
Mm-hmm.
Mostly, because really with a guy, you could hardly go wrong, right?
You're a tuxedo.
You're just wearing a tux, you know? So it was mostly the girls. And I kept saying to myself as I looked down the list, you know, I said, where are the fathers or the mothers, you know, the parents
right.
of these kids?
Because they're seeking because attention, right?
Exactly.
They
they're seeking everything is everywhere, open up everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm saying, where are the parents?
Right.
I would never allow my child out of the house like that.
Right, right. That's right.
I would never,
yeah.
you know. And so to me, that's the way they're crying. You
yes.
know, I see the young, and you have a lot of programs, you know. So I used to do programs for girls and young women. You know, I mentor young women and girls, and things like that. And I know they are crying. Mm-hmm. And I know that what they're really crying for is the attention of their father, the love and the validation of their fathers. Mm-hmm. And so fathers, you really, really play a crucial role in modeling what manhood is all about and in building the worth and the esteem of your daughters. Mm-hmm. And just be present, like Abdul said, just show up. Mm-hmm. That's all. You don't need any other skills, but be present. This Father's Day, be present. And that's the challenge. So yes, this the daddy-daughter dance, that was what I actually saw.
Yes.
You created this event on Facebook and I got a notification and I thought, wow, how cool is this? Because this is something very dear to my heart, mm-hmm. you know. I said, how cool is this that someone is hosting this, you know, daddy-daughter and encouraging fathers to, you know, take their daughters out and, on a dance, on a date and mm-hmm. and celebrate, which is the challenge.
Yes.
You know.
They should come.
You know, they should come, that's absolutely.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
You know, on Saturday, June 20th, mm-hmm. 6 to 9 p.m. at Taste Buds, you know, Main mm-hmm. Street in East Hartford. Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. And so you could go to my website, royalproclamations.com. You know where to find me. You'll find me on Facebook. I'm going to be posting. You have this e-file, right?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to be posting this on my wall. For more information as well, you can go to my people -connecticut.com.
That's right.
To learn more, to register. But tell us in a few minutes, because we only have a few minutes left, the inspiration behind the daddy-daughter dance and what the results have been, what have been the testimonials mm-hmm. from daughters attending, you know, the inaugural event last year.
So for the last 10 years, we've done a Father's Day brunch. Or okay. cookout. So we used to do okay. every year we do a cookout or a brunch.
Yeah.
And so last year we started thinking, okay, this is gonna be it was our 11th cookout. I mean brunch. And I said we should add something else the day before.
Mm.
And so you know both of my daughters were home, and I was saying you know my little daughter you know needs the. I need to take her out. We're going to take her out. So,
yeah.
you know, a lot of times these ideas are just like, you know, when I'm in the office, we're just fooling around talking
yeah.
about stuff. And so we say, we're going to do a daddy-daughter dance. That we need one. And I think the inspiration might have come in Philadelphia. They have a huge daddy-daughter
dance.
I mean,
really?
They do it at their convention center.
Oh, wow.
And so imagine if we were doing it at the convention
yes.
center.
Yes, I'm hoping
that's the
that
future.
This will, exactly,
yes.
this will evolve to that.
Yes.
And so if you're watching, you know, this is very, let's make it happen in Connecticut.
Yes.
You know. Saturday, June 20th.
You get dinner.
Oh, no.
You got arts and crafts.
This is so worth it.
You
it's
got
so
face painting. I mean, and I'll tell you, last year we had daughters as young as 2.
Yes.
And daughters as old as 40-something. I don't know. I said maybe it was late 30s. I didn't want to mess with her age. But
yeah.
So, and I already know that this year we're going to have even more older, you know.
Cause, awesome.
So,
awesome.
So it
it's
goes
never
back.
Too late.
It's not,
that's the
right.
other thing.
That's
oh,
right.
you just want to touch on that.
Yeah.
That just came to me, really.
Mm-hmm.
It's never too late because there's some dad watching and thinking, you know what, I wish I was, you know, when
right.
I was younger, I you know. You can make up for lost time.
You can do it now.
You can do it now.
Yes.
You can do it now. It doesn't matter how old your daughter is.
Mm-mm.
They're still secretly, you know, I had to go through a lot of therapy for me, you
mm-hmm.
know, and get that validation before I could now receive validation from God,
mm-hmm.
you know. So it's never, never too late.
Never late.
So, yeah. So
we,
there
we,
is
we
open
welcome
to daughters
all,
of all
that's
ages, right?
All
right?
ages because,
absolutely.
Like you just said, the daughters would appreciate it.
Exactly.
You know, it always comes back to that time, though.
Yes.
You know, think about it. If she goes to the dance with her dad,
yes.
that's the time that she gets one-on-one with dad.
Yeah.
Nobody else tonight. It's
exactly.
just us.
Exactly.
And so
it makes her feel special.
That's
yeah,
right.
very
that's right.
special
it's important.
And loved.
Yeah.
Awesome. Awesome. We're coming to the close of the program, the broadcast.
Mm-hmm.
The time goes so fast. Again, it's been real pleasure having you on Inspired Success. Thank you very much
yeah.
for coming. You do so many amazing things in the community with the Dream Support Network as well.
Mm-hmm.
You know, inspiring and motivating people to go for their dreams.
Chase those dreams.
You know, you do this. I know you and your wife, you also do the Young Girls Conference,
yep.
you know,
yep.
once a year.
Mm-hmm.
So you're doing amazing work in our community.
Thank
and We need more and more and more of you. We need more men to step up. So fathers, okay, that's my challenge for you, okay? June 20th, pick up a ticket for your daughter and yourself, mypeople-connecticut.com, or hit me up on Facebook. I'm going to be putting this up shortly. Tremendous, tremendous event. I really commend you for that. And just as we, before we close, you know, if you look into that camera again, just two sentences, just try and encourage some dad for Father's Day, a dad who is feeling depressed, who's feeling like, you know, I've failed. You know, I know many of fathers kind of feel they failed. They're struggling themselves, you know, they're hurting themselves. And you can't give what you don't have,
That's right. That's right.
And so sometimes, you know, we need to encourage the fathers. The fathers need healing. The fathers need, you know, jobs. And they need different kind of things for to help them perform their role better. You know, so I just want you to look into the camera, encourage some father, speak heart to heart, you know, and speak to a bro. And encourage them this Father's Day.
Well, this is what I'll do. Let's take it a step further. If there's a father out there right now that's saying, man, I really wish I could go to that dance, but I don't have the $50 to be able to take my daughter to the dance, hit us up on Facebook. You know, the daddy-daughter dance is here. It's going to be in East Hartford. We'll give you some tickets. We'll give at least one father some tickets. I don't want everybody calling. We need to balance things out. But what I'm saying is that this is an opportunity to, you know, it could be an opportunity to repair a relationship. This could be an opportunity to build a relationship. This could be an opportunity to make a relationship better than it's ever been. You know, your daughters need you. Your daughters want you. And this dance is like, the way I look at it, it's like an annual event where after you come this year, every year afterward, she's going to be looking forward to it. And so don't miss out on this. Don't say, you know, you'll do it next year or you'll do something else. This is the time. Don't waste time and come out to the Daddy Daughter Dance June 20th, 6 to 9 p.m. at Taste Buds.
Thank you very, very much. And that was very generous of you. So there's been one lucky dad
there's
there.
There's a dad out there. Get in contact with us.
Just do it. Just do it. Let's just do it. I really, really want to thank you. I mean, you're, like I said, you're doing amazing, amazing work in our community, especially in the Black community. We need more fathers to step up, you know. We need more fathers to be involved, you know. And what about non-biological fathers now, you know, in 1 minute? Because so you're not a biological father, but you could be a foster father. You could be a mentor father. You could be a spiritual father, an uncle. You could step in and play that role for somebody else.
I'm going to tell you this real quick. I know we're running out of time. I already know that there's a number of daughters out there whose fathers aren't going to take them to the dance. They want to go to the dance. But their fathers, for some reason, they're just not going to do it. But there's an uncle that could take him.
Absolutely.
There's somebody else in that
there's
family that could step up.
There's a family friend.
That's
there's
right.
There's a, you know, foster dad.
That's
there's
right.
a spiritual dad.
That's right.
You know, step up, fathers, for Father's Day. That's my challenge to you, Princess Bola. So, you know, save our daughters. You know, they're crying out. And you have the power, you know, to save them, to step in, to, you know, help them to find their sense of identity and worth. Just show up and be present. That's all it takes, you know. And a little investment in something like this goes a long, long, long way. And so, Abdul, I want to say a real thank you again for being on Inspired Success.
You.
It's a real pleasure talking with you. We're out of time, not out of words. And so this is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep smiling. Put a smile on your face. Life's too short. You know, keep learning, keep networking, keep believing, keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. And happy Father's Day to all my dads out there. You know, I can't attend. Otherwise, I'd have said I'll see you there. But I'll tell Abdul to be looking out for you.
You can come. Sure.
RoyalProclamations.com, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn. I'm everywhere. I'll see you next month. Thank you for watching. God bless. Bye.
Thank you. This is good.